Only when the last tree has died, the last river has been poisoned, the last fish has been caught, will we realize that we can't eat money. Considering the gruesome situation, which may be a possibility on Earth, in the absence of preservation and conservation of environment, MRV had rightly taken steps to prevent this eventuality by starting its own in-house environmental program, incorporated in the curriculum and collaborating with TERI, the Energy and Resource Institute, 3 years ago. Our collaboration with TERI has widened our perspectives on environment, making us realize that each step, no matter how big or small it is, counts when taken in the right direction. TERI has also given us a platform to showcase our talents with various fun-filled activities and competitions. Today's wastage is tomorrow's shortage. Hence, reuse, reduce, and recycle are the watchwords of environmentalists. Initiative was taken in the same direction by Project Search with the first of its kind, Gardens to Classroom Initiative. In their attempt to sensitize the students to waste management, they had to collect Tetra Pak cartons, which were to be used for recycling into furniture that will be donated to an underprivileged school. We are proud to say that this year we collected the maximum Tetra Paks and won the Best School Performing Contest organized by TERI Tetra Pak. The most exciting part of this victory was our opportunity to meet Sir Robert Swan, who believes in the maxim, example is better than precept, and drove to MRV on bicycle, promoting the cause of save fuel, as fuel is like time. Once gone, will never come back. It was a memorable event in the history of MRV family to meet a personality instrumental in Clean the Antarctica project. We can also boast of having our little brand ambassador, Aditya Patil, collecting the maximum Tetra Paks and being a winner of video making competition on What Would You Do to Make Tetra Pak Carton Recycling Fun? What Can You Do to Preserve Antarctica? MRV was on cloud 9 when Aditya Patil was selected to be at Pune and meet Sir Robert Swan once again. Our students were introduced to the concept of composting and organic farming 4 years ago, as we believe in the dictum, you do, you understand. They then took the concept further and introduced it in their own houses and neighborhood. Don't litter, it makes the world bitter. This knowledge is extremely essential during Ganesh Chaturthi festival in India. One can't expect clean waters lashing the shore or children playing sand castles in hygienic sand after this festival, as most idols and other waste, including flowers and thermocol, are scattered on the beaches during immersion. Our students took up the beach cleanup drive to rid our beaches from these hazardous materials. Not only that, our children actively came forward to spread the awareness to reduce noise pollution by forming a human chain which got media coverage. We took one more baby step in our giant leap when we became the winner of Yes! Young Energy Savers, which was a new TV animation project aimed at creating awareness among children about energy consumption. No wonder, when you save power, you energize the future. Recycle, rekindle, rethink, and be creative. Our children learned about being creative even with waste when they visited Anand Bhave's paper recycling center at Andheri. The furniture he makes can be broken down or reused, or it can be buried. In short, it can be decomposed. This reminds me of what Sir Robert Swan had said. The greatest danger to our planet is the belief that someone else will save it. The last great exploration on Earth is to survive on Earth. Our children also visited Panasonic and saw technology that saves electricity, making us appreciate the use of alternate sources of energy. Ignorance today brings a dark tomorrow, and MRV has been successfully trying to bridge the gap between ignorance and knowledge to shape a better future for Earth. After all, it's the only Earth that we have.